located on Premium Hotel Hill, Mokola, Ibadan, and we call our grounds Place of Refuge. The Lord says to us that 2021 is the year of resurgence, restoration, and recovery. Hallelujah! As you come along with us, you will surely partake of the same grace. Currently, our Sunday services start at 10 a.m. and on Wednesdays, we meet for prevailing prayers and Bible study at 5:30 p.m. Nigeria time. You're always welcome to join us in any of these programs, either face-to-face or live, online, on Facebook or YouTube. The word of God to us this year is from 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 8, KJV. Pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail, recover all. Welcome to the latter.
Good evening to you wherever you're worshiping with us this evening. This is our midweek service devoted to prevailing prayers and Bible study. And I can assure you that the ministers for this evening are prepared by God and they are filled with the Holy Ghost to be a blessing to our lives. I can assure you that wherever you have been linked to this service, the power of our God will reach unto you in the name of Jesus, and the Lord will attend to your needs in Jesus' name. Amen. It's time for worship now.
Jesus.
Is faithful. Let's give him praise. Let's exalt his holy name. Let's magnify him. Let's adore him. He's been a faithful God. He's been a faithful God. Dear Lord, we lift up our voices in the assembly of the saints tonight to bless your holy name, to magnify you, to adore you. You are a good God. We lift you up, Father. We bless your name. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We give you all the adoration. We thank you, Father, Lord, for another privilege to be found in your awesome presence. Thank you for bringing us. Thank you, Father, Lord, for all the grace. Thank you, Father, Lord, for your presence that has been evident in the life of each and every one of us.
those of us who are here and our people who are with us online, we want to thank you for your power. We want to thank you for your mercies. We want to thank you for provision. We want to thank you for divine protection. 1,000 is falling by our side and 10,000 is falling by our right hand side. You have never allowed evil to befall anyone in our midst. You have kept us. You have kept us. You have kept us by the power of your might. We therefore, Lord, thank you for another privilege, O Lord God, Father, to be here tonight. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We give you all the adoration. Thank you, blessed Redeemer, for your power. Thank you for your presence that has been here ever before we gather. And as we gather tonight, we will ask that your name alone be glorified. Thank you, dear Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. This is the time for prevailing prayers. And for those of us who are here, we are familiar with what God had been doing at this material time. And those of you who are joining us online, this is a very, very sacred and a special time that God had commanded us to bring our burdens, our cares, our fears unto his feet, and that our God is bound to answer us. And you know, there are testimonies that are accrued as a result of this. And tonight is not going to be an exception. For those of you who are joining us online, if there is any request that you know, have, it's time for you to present it before the Lord. Distance is not a barrier to our God. And those of us who are here, I'm sure, you know, we have quite a number, but time did not permit us. But I have one here with me from one of our members tonight. And this person is requesting that the children of God join him or her to ask God, that God will show forth his power in his life, in his family, and over his job. And our God is more than able to do this. We are going to join this, this child of God to lift up this request unto the Lord God Almighty, that the God who answers prayers, the Lord will answer the request of the writer of these prayers. Can we lift up our voice wherever you are now? Let's lift up our voice and let's begin to ask that the Lord in his infinite mercies, that the Lord in his infinite mercies, it will show forth his power in the life of the writer of this request. I don't know him, but Jehovah God knows the writer. He knows the family. He knows the situation in which they are. And we are requesting, the person is requesting, that he want God to show forth. And when God shows forth, let's ask that the Lord will show forth in his life. He will show forth his power. He will show up for his family, and he'll show up for his over his job in this infinite message in the name of Jesus. We commit the writer of this request unto you, dear Father. He or she is asking the Lord will show forth. You are alive. You are not a dead God. You are alive. Elijah asked and he said, the God that answers by fire, let him be God. You answered and you showed forth. You showed forth. Father, tonight is not going to be an exception. The Bible says you are the same yesterday. You are the same today and forevermore you remain the same. You never change, but you can change situation. Change the situation of this family. Change the situation of the writer of this request. And show forth your power in the name of Jesus. Let there be the miraculous. Let there be miracles. Let there be divine intervention over his life, over his family in the name of Jesus. Whatever may be the challenge, whatever may be the trouble, oh God of heaven, you that are seated in heaven, we ask the Lord you will arise tonight and you will intervene in the name of the Lord Jesus. You will intervene over his job. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, we are asking, show forth your power, show forth your presence. Let the glory of the Lord be revealed in this life, in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. And if you have any requests, wherever you are, it's time for you to begin to lift your burdens unto the Lord. It's time for you to request that the Lord himself will do that which no man can do. And I'm sure our God is more than able. Tonight, he will answer you. And tonight, you know, there's going to be miracles. It will cause you to laugh in the name of Jesus. He will remove reproaches from your life. He will remove shame there shall be the miraculous in the name of Jesus. And Lord, your people, O Lord God, Father, shall be filled with the glory of the power of our God in the name of Jesus. We thank you because it is our month to recover whatever is missing in any life, in any family. Lord, let there be total and complete recovery in the name of Jesus. As we pursue in our requests, in our prayers unto you, in the name of the Lord Jesus, your word says, ask and it shall be given. And as your children are asking, wherever they are right now, O God of heaven, hear in the name of Jesus and attend to the cry of their heart, to the glory of your name. We want to thank you because you have heard us tonight. We commit the next segment into your hand. We're asking that God will show forth your power in the name of Jesus. And your name, O God, shall be glorified. Thank you because of you have heard us. And all glory shall be unto your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Hallelujah. Worship team, thank you very much. I want to say good evening to every one of us. And I am sure that we have had a good day, each and every one of us, wherever our walk may have taken us today. Am I correct to say that we have had a good time today? Yes, hallelujah. God has been faithful. When we say yes like that, we're saying God showed up faithfully in each of our situations and circumstances. And that's a testimony to his goodness. So, we're welcome to our midweek service again. Wherever you may be under the firmament that is called heaven, the Lord is mindful, not only of those of us who are here face to face, but also of people who are on different parts of the globe. And because he's mindful of us, he has sent us a word. May our ears and our hearts be opened unto that word in the name of Jesus. I'm going to start tonight by putting in perspective the life application lessons that we have been having from that word that God gave us for the year. Life application lessons. In other words, those practical steps that we can start to take immediately from the scripture that God has given unto us. We have learned that we are to be in constant fellowship with God. We are to ask him whenever we need to take a step. That is crucial. It's a life lesson. It is not so spiritual, let me put it like that. It's something we must begin to do because the year has actually begun. We have also learned that we are not to consign our priest into oblivion, into a place where our priest cannot be reached, into a place where our priest cannot reach us also. We have learned that we need to go back to things that we left undone before. Maybe we made an attempt and those attempts were not good enough. And we probably thought, well, this cannot be done. We have learned that we need to go back to them, revisit those offices, those applications, those proposals. And on Sunday, we learned that we need to build a reliable team. We need to build a reliable team. A team that will stand by us at all times. And also we learned that without goals, there will be nothing to show forth in the life of the believer. So we all are supposed to sit down, break the laziness, and set goals, and also map out the strategies, the action points that will lead to achieving those goals. We had 5 points on Sunday, and I believe we all understand it. Now, Today we are going to add one more application lesson, one more life application to that list. The title of the message today is Building Resources. Building Resources. It is not strange, I'm sure, to any one of us that we need to build resources for the year to be what we want it to be. We need to build resources. I'm going to take us back to 1 Samuel in chapter 30, and I'm going to be reading three or four verses, four from verse 7. 1 Samuel chapter 30 from verse 7 to verse 10. Says, and David said to Abiathar the priest, Ahimelech's son, I pray thee, bring me hither the ephod. And Abiathar brought thither the ephod to David. And David inquired at the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I overtake them? And he, God, answered David, pursue. For thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail recover all. So David went, he and the 600 men that were with him, and came to the brook Besor, where those that were left behind stayed. Verse 10. But David pursued, he and 400 men, for 200 abode behind, which were so faint that they could not go over the brook Besor. Now, I need us to understand that this incident that we are reading about in 1 Samuel chapter 30 became the switch that brought the fulfillment of God's promise in the life of David. It became the switch that brought the fulfillment of David's destiny. If you look at from verse 26 of that chapter, you will notice that David sent the spoils of war to different places. From verse 26 to verse 31, the Bible details the places, the people to whom David sent the spoil. And by 2 Samuel in chapter 2, David already became enthroned as king over the house of Judah in Hebron. So, this event became the precursor to his enthronement, which was what God had said will happen to him years before. What does that mean? It means that without building resources, some of those things will linger for longer than expected. I'm going to go back to verse 9. It says, so David went and 600 men. Certainly, David needed that resource that triggered the process. And the resource, like we learned on Sunday, is the people. 600 people. And when he was going to pursue 400 people, that was the resource that David had. He went with them. He could not have done it without them. Verse 9 says, so David went, he and the 600 men. And then verse 10 says, but David pursued, he and 400 men. He could not have done it alone. Now on Sunday we learned, and it was clear, that we need such men around us. We need such men around us. Now, imagine that David had no man before this time. He is willing to put that team together. But he had not started by the time Ziklag was burnt with fire. Now, he needed to pursue that troop, and he would still have to build his team at that time. What do you think would be the result? He knew he needed a team, reliable, but he was yet to build it. I have two questions here. How quickly do you think it would have taken him to put the army together if he was just going to put the army together to be able to chase the adversary? It would take a long time. Actually, his own mind was already in a panic. He will make more mistakes. Because you commit errors when you're under pressure. Second question, would the pursuit and recovery have been possible at all? While he was putting the team together, that troop was going to be traveling farther and farther away. So here, the resource that David needed, which helped him, was human resource. Human resource. My attention tonight is on another resource, financial resource. We need it. And like we have learned tonight, that it must be ready when the challenge arrives on our doorstep. And I know that it is easier said than done that men and women will start to put financial resources aside. It's not easy. I know that. So some of the things I'm going to be saying tonight will not be strange to you. You probably know it before, but have you done it? That's the question. I believe God is stirring us up to begin to do the things we knew to do but did not do. Let it not become sin unto us. This year will bring certain opportunities which can only be harnessed by the availability of funds. I'd like us to understand that. When opportunities come and you have the resource to take advantage of them, believe me, you are confident. You just go ahead and you are able to harness the opportunity. And unless we build funds over time, we will miss out on all the opportunities. And that will be unfortunate. Now, I see a pattern for accumulating financial resources in the Bible. And I want us to look at it and use it as a template for ourselves. And that template is found in the book of Genesis. Genesis in chapter 41. I have no doubt in my heart that we know that story too well. So, it's a reminder. Now, we are supposed to actually read from verse 15 and go all the way to the end. But because of time, yeah, at least we should go all the way to verse 44. But because of time, I'm going to skip verses and we're just going to pick what we need. But for your notes, please, write from verse 15 to verse 44. So I'm going to pick, like I said, so my first pick will be verse 17. It is the story of Pharaoh's dream. First, he saw cows. Seven very fat cows came out of, he was standing on the bank of the river. And those cows came up out of the river. You find those in verse 17 and verse 18. I stood upon the bank of the river. Verse 18 says, and behold, there came up out of the river. And according to Revelation chapter 17, verse 15, that sea, that river, speaks of people. People. Money will never fall from heaven. Money will come from people to us. When I go to work and at the end of the month I am paid a salary, it is coming through a man, my employer. If God desires to bless me beyond the salary, he's also going to stir up the heart of a man or a woman, a human being. So those resources will come. What are we to do about it is what we are looking at this evening as we share together. I would like to jump. Let's go to verse 26, verse 25. And Joseph said unto Pharaoh, the dream of Pharaoh is one, the one of the cows and the one of that very robust plant that he saw. He said, the dream of Pharaoh is one. God has showed Pharaoh what he is about to do. The seven good kine are 7 years, and the seven good ears of corn are 7 years also. The dream is one. And the seventh thing, an ill-favored kine that came up after them, are 7 years. And the seven empty ears blasted with the east wind shall be 7 years of famine. Now, I see these two verses as a summary of the seasons of life. There is a time, there is a season when the abundance will flow so much, and if you are not careful, you will wonder what you are supposed to do with money. Nigeria was once like that. And our head of state said money was not our problem. We were only looking for how to spend it. Unfortunately, now we have known how to spend it, but we don't know how to make more. We just share and share and share money and share money and share money. But there is the other season. They go together, hand in hand. Either we like it or not. That other season, the flow may slow down. Now, if we eat all that we made during the rainy season, what will we eat during the dry season? Because God has made life with two seasons. It is not a demon. It is not the witches from my hometown. It will always be like that. It is the season of life. It rotates. Let's move on. So there are two seasons. I'm going to jump to verse 33. What kind of people are we supposed to be in 2021? There is a need to become a type of person for this year to be truly the year of restoration unto us. Verse 33 says, now therefore let Pharaoh look out a man. What are the two qualifications of this man? He is to be discreet. That's verse 33. He is to be discreet. The New King James Bible says the man is supposed to be discerning. Discerning. Able to know what should come ahead. Able to see beyond what everybody needs to see. This man should be discreet. And to be discreet means to be mentally separate. The word translated discreet in the Authorized King James Version means to be mentally separate. Not to be easily carried away by what everybody thinks. Mentally separate. Not to be like other people. That word means to be cunning. Very cunning, wise. It means to be discerning also. It means to be prudent. Not somebody who spends all. You know, like the people around here in Nigeria, in this part of Nigeria, will say, you should not eat with 10 fingers. I'm sure there's nobody here who didn't know that before. But the question is how many of us have practiced it. And we need to begin now. A discreet man is not flamboyant. A discreet man is a man who is able to delay gratification, delay enjoyment. I have money, yes. It is sitting in my account, yes. I want to go to Domino's Pizza. To Domino's because I want to eat pizza. Okay, fine, I go today. Tomorrow, I feel like going again. What should I do? Go again? And then on Friday, I like to go again. Why? After all, there's money in my account. So in 2021, a child of God who is part of this commission and who wants to really achieve what God has said we will achieve, resurgence, restoration, and recovery, will be a discreet man. I can enter a store and see shoes of all categories. One is 100. One is 70. One is 50. One is 20. If the one for 10 is looking nice, I'm going to go for 10. That's the honest truth. I'm just being prudent. Now, if that's not prudence to you, fine, do what is prudence to you. But for me, that's prudence, because that money can be put on something else. Who is looking at my shoe anyway? You think I see your shoe when you come? Or your tie or your jacket? Let's delay gratification. It will pay us. Needs may come unannounced. And because it is unannounced, and I just bought another shoe yesterday, I have four. I then decided, fine, fantastic, let me buy one more, and then the need comes up today. What happens? The second qualification of the man who will do well this year, apart from being discreet, is being wise. To be wise is to be intelligent, to be skillful in the use of money in this particular case, skillful in the deployment of resources, skillful. If I don't know what to do, I will not be afraid to ask. Sorry, how can I put money in a place? Where can I put money that will make it yield? I've had to walk up to one of us about this time last year, sat him down and I told him, look, all that you know in your head, put in my head because I need it. And he did. He tried. So the wise man is intelligent, he's skillful, he's cunning, and he's subtle. He doesn't show. He's just subtle. He travels, moves forward in a manner that does not announce him or her to everybody. He's subtle. And such was the man that Pharaoh was advised to pick and to set over the land of Israel if the resources God was bringing were not going to be a waste. So, Pharaoh decided, look, you are the one we need. And he told Pharaoh what to do. So we're looking at verse 34 now. Genesis 41, verse 34. Let Pharaoh do this. And that is the template. And let him appoint officers. Those officers are rules that we need to give ourselves. They are boundaries we need to set for ourselves. And we are going to make sure we do not break those boundaries. These are the things I'm not going to put money on this year. Say it to yourself. Write it down. Let it be binding on you. Those are the officers that Pharaoh will pick to be in charge. Discipline is the officer. Those officers are to be over the land and take up the what? What does verse 34 say? Thank you, sir. Take up the fifth part. The fifth part of the land of Egypt in the seven plenteous years. The fifth part is simply 20%. 1/5 of 100 is what? 20. At least we know that Muri Manu is 100 naira and Muri Kon is 20. So it's 20%. Now that was the strategy that this very wise, very shrewd, gifted man of God gave the nation of Egypt, and Egypt prospered by it. Verse 35 says, they started to lay up corn and they started to keep food. And those are two things we must do. Lay up and keep. But then, I have an application that I think will be more specific to us in our generation. Verse 34 says fifth part, which is 20%. But I'm proposing certain ratios that we may adopt if we so wish. And that adoption can be immediate. And we can begin to build on from there. Number one, the first 10%, We give it to God. Non-negotiable. If anybody is still here that does not pay his tithe or her tithe under the guise of it will not be enough for me, believe me, it's not a curse. It will never be enough. Why? The God factor that we need to make it is the one we are shutting out. We are shutting out the God factor. So the first 10% goes to God. That's a duty if we are believers. It's a duty. And you should brace up if you have been faithful in tithing and you have been tithing the tithe of 10,000, the tithe of 100,000. The day you have to tithe 10 million, I'm sure you will stagger a little bit and say, tithe of 10 million is 1 million. No, that can do a lot. Yeah, it can do a lot, but God, to whom you are giving it, can bring a lot more. Number two, the next 10% is to pay yourself. I'm sure you are wondering, how am I paying myself? They pay me salary. Now, out of your salary, how much do you spend on yourself? Very little. You spend on family, you spend on your car, you repair things in the house, you do this, you do that. How much do you really, really eat? So, pay yourself 10%. It is not to be touched under any circumstance. It's your savings. Pretend you don't even have it. And I'm serious about that. Pretend it does not exist. If possible, do like an automatic debit on your account. And just pretend it doesn't exist. No ATM card, nothing. That is the one that is tough. Because for most of us, it's difficult to see money and then I'm telling myself there's no money. But we need to come to the point where we can tell ourselves there's no money. This money is not money. It's not my own. Number three, we separate another 10% for emergencies. You know, the second 10% must not be touched, even for emergencies. Now, if you are saying, they will say I'm too callous, that I'm not helping people. Okay, another 10% for emergencies. If you consider it an emergency, then you can take this 10%, but not the second one. And then number four, what percentage remains? Thank you very much, Mass and SAS. 70% is what is left. That 70%, you need to allow God to lead you on how to use it. I said this many years ago, and somebody rose up in the meeting and said God gave us a brain so that we can give him rest, and that he did not need to go and ask God again. He would just spend his money. After all, he worked for it. Okay. But this is what I am used to. I try to be sure I have a release from God to spend money. And I'm not a rich man, but it has helped me. I would have probably been poorer if that mindset was not there. Prudence needs to guide the use of the remaining 70%. Prudence. Here, we still need to bring back delayed gratification. Can you be good to yourself and ask yourself, why do I need to buy this thing? If I hold on, can't the money be better used? For shoes, for clothes, for house rent, for... If I find a house that they want me to come and rent for 750,000 and there's another one for 200,000, I will take the one for 200,000. I don't own either of the houses. I want to be able to build my own. Why would I go and put 1.5 million? Now, I hope I'm not offending your mental, your decision. But I'm saying, whatever we can achieve with a lower amount of money, we achieve with a lower amount of money. Not necessarily throw the bigger amount at meeting our need. That's all. If you didn't hear anything, hear that. Always attempt with all of your power and might to achieve the same purpose with a lower amount of money. And this is what I have noticed as I close. When we get into that cycle, that's what it seems like to me. When we get into that cycle, it's like everything around me begins to obey my cycle. I don't get kpajawiri. If you don't understand Yoruba much, you may not understand what kpajawiri is. Kpajawiri is when a sudden need arises and they are telling you, you must come now, and spend money now, over something that probably does not even concern you. Sometimes it may concern you, but God can put it at bay. Because once you begin, it's like how many of us remember rope jumping that we used to do? Somebody holds the rope on one end, another on the other end, and they are both, doing it like that. And you are there trying to watch for when to jump in, and then you start to go like that. When you begin, it's like you are jumping into the rope. But once you enter the rhythm, believe me, some things leave you alone. They leave you alone. They don't jump with you into the cycle. So tonight, I believe that, like verse 41 says, we are to build resources which will help us to harness opportunities that are ahead of us. What we need to start to do now is to lay up. In Joseph's case, he was laying up corn under the hand of Pharaoh. He was keeping food in the cities. What are we going to be keeping from tonight? I believe the Lord will help us. But I believe also that we need to take a firm decision tonight to begin some of these things. It is not a good thing to the mind of a man when you look at your bank account and you find 10 naira, and you look at your pocket and you don't even find anything. And some of us boast about it and say, look, home and abroad, I have nothing. I don't think we should be there. I don't think God wants us to be there, because tomorrow morning an opportunity can knock on our door. Do you have so and so and so amount? Because if you do, this thing is here and it's just an opportunity. And then you say, I don't. I'm not sure it's a helpful thing. So, I know it is tough to save. I'm not saying it's cheap, but I'm saying that where we find it tough, God can be our help. But most certainly, it is one of the things we must begin to do as the year progresses. Can we rise on our feet tonight? I don't know where any of us is at in the issue we have discussed tonight, but I think it's time to go to God and say, Lord, help me. Help me. Lord, I need you to help me. I don't really know what to do, but I need you to help me. I find it difficult to do these things, but I know if you help me, I will be helped.
In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. The Lord will help all of us in Jesus' name. Let's be on our seats. Let's be seated as we listen to the announcements. We would like to welcome you to the latter house. Glory be to God. We also welcome those watching online. We are glad you could join us. The word of God to us this month is from 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 8, KJV. And David inquired at the Lord, saying, "Shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I overtake them?" And he answered him, "Pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail recover all." Let's say this together. 2021 is my year of resurgence, restoration, and recovery. Hallelujah. It is imperative that we must continue to maintain social distancing and obey all Nigeria Center for Disease Control regulations. The spread of COVID-19 is real, and there's a resurgence facing the world. So, we need to protect ourselves and our loved ones. You will need to wear a clean face mask throughout the service and everywhere on the premises. You must also sanitize your hands before entry to the auditoriums. We have zero tolerance for defaulters. Don't let your guard down just yet. Our next service will be our Sunday service on Sunday, February the 21st at 10 a.m. Nigeria time. It will be both face-to-face and online. Our Facebook page is www.facebook.com/TLH expression. Give your written prayer request to the ushers before start of service, or send ahead by email to pastor@thelatterhouse.org. You can also fill in your prayer request anytime on our website, www.thelatterhouse.org, and it will be taken at the next service. The February Pastors Management Committee meeting will hold on Wednesday, February the 21st, 2021, after the service at 7 p.m. prompt. All pastors' reports should have reached the church office by now. It's time to give our tithes and offerings. You can make bank transfers to Guarantee Trust Bank account number 044862-3282. Again, 044862-3282. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, God of all grace, bless our sacrifice of love to you as we give now, and send your blessings to all areas of our lives and to our land where we need your heavenly intervention at this time. In Jesus' name, amen. We thank you for worshiping with us today, especially if this is your first time. If you're in any of the auditoriums, please identify yourself to an usher so you can collect the gift we have for you. We bless God that you made it and look forward to you joining us again on Sunday. Time is 10 a.m. Until then and beyond, may the Lord bless and keep you. Amen.
Make his face shine upon you, be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen.
favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his presence go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. He's with you, he's with you in the morning, in the evening, in your coming and your going, in your weeping and rejoicing. He's for you, 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 he's for you.
Was awesome. We believe that you have enjoyed this service with us, and we hope that you will join us this same time next week. For any inquiry and prayer request, you can contact us through the various channels displayed on the screen. Thank you, and God bless you.